Namaskara to everyone. I'm very happy to share with you this wonderful instrument, ghatam. Well, ghatam is a traditional South Indian percussion instrument. In Sanskrit, ghatam means a pot. Even though it looks like a pot, but it's a very, very special pot. Well, nobody knows when exactly it came to the live act. For about more than 150 years, it's been there in Carnatic music, and many, many great vidwans, the doyens of Carnatic music, have contributed immensely for the growth and evolution of the ghatam, like Ghatam Sundaram Iyer, Palani Krishna Iyer, Umayalpuram Kodandaram Iyer, T.S. Vilvadri Iyer, Alangudi Ramchandran, K.M. Vaidyanathan, Bengaluru Manjunath, Bengaluru K. Venkatram, Umayalpuram Narayanaswamy Iyer, K.N. Krishnamurthy, and many, many musicians. But there's one musician who has taken this instrument to every corner in the world. He's one and only our Paramaguru Vidwan Vikkuven Ayyangaram sir. There is no gharana system in Carnatic music, but if there is any gharana for ghatam, it has to be Vikku gharana. Ghatataran, a unique and brainchild concept, was started by my guru Vidushi Sukanya Ram Gopal in the year 1993. She has given a new dimension for this ghatam, and now with all the contribution from many, many musicians over the past few decades, it has centered itself on world stage, be it any genre. From Carnatic music, now it belongs to the world music. It's part of Hindustani music or jazz or flamenco, any genres, it is there. So this is the evolution of the ghatam for you. And where do we get this instrument? How do we make this instrument? That's an interesting thing. Briefly, I'll explain you how do they make the instrument. Well, previously they used to make in Chennai, even in Bengaluru. But the ones which are available in Manamadurai are the best. Manamadurai is a very small village, about 40-45 kilometers from Madurai in Tamil Nadu state. Although Manamadurai is an important center for pottery in South India, there's only one family for the last four generations they make this instrument. And they're constantly improvising and innovating. So how do they make instrument? There are about five types of clay from different pots are mixed and kept for a couple of days. And previously they used to mix by hands. Now they have a machine which does the entire mixing. Then they took to the spinning wheel by molding the clay, which will take the shape of the ghatam. Then the interesting thing is they have that wooden block, which by the wooden block they tap for more than 2000 times to get the particular pitch. In the last stage, you know, before they used to take it to the open fire. Now they have an electric kiln, and because of this electric kiln, the damage is relatively less. So this is how they make the instrument. A special mention about Shri Ramesh from Manamadurai for keeping this tradition and bringing many innovations in ghatam making. So this is about ghatam, and just briefly explaining about the important features of the ghatam. It's a eco-friendly, it's a weather-friendly, it's a vegan instrument, and it has all the five elements of nature. And the weight of the ghatam varies anywhere between 6 to 10, sometimes 12 kgs also. And it has a particular pitch. Every ghatam, for example, this is tuned to E pitch, and we play in both the hands. We use all the 10 fingers. And how do we tune the instrument is we can increase the pitch, we can also decrease the pitch either by putting clay dough inside this ghatam, or even just put some little bit of water here, we can decrease the volume of pitch, we can decrease the pitch of the ghatam. So I'm just going to play a short solo for you all.